thought about it like this. It is the 10th anniversary of 9/11, and if we could work out really hard for an hour and sweat and be tired and fatigued, I mean, that's the least we can do for everybody else who has passed away for us, who is overseas, so the long wad was not an issue.
You guys ready to have a good time today?
Yeah.
Are you cold?
No.
It's beautiful out, right? All of the athletes are going to start at the first jetty right there. On Rob's 3-2-1 go, they'll be running all the way down the other jetty where those buckets are there. They're going to retrieve the buckets. They're going to come all the way back to this jetty here, okay? They're going to fill the buckets up, and that's when the wad begins. They will farmers walk all the way up the beach. Anytime they put the buckets down, they do 5 burpees. At the end of the lane, they do 25 bucket front squats each. They also have to do it 6 times. On the 6th one, they don't do squats, they sprint back up to meet their partners over here. In lane 2, the other 2 partners of that team are doing inchworm hand release push-ups to stand the entire lane. At the end of their lane, they do 125 air squats each. Then they get to the 3rd set of cones. As a team, they are going to army crawl the entire way back down. Then, as a team, in the 4th lane, they're going to do forward rolls all the way back down. Then, as a team, they will run around the perimeter. They will retrieve their buckets. They will run them any way. They can carry them farmer's walk, they can shoulder them, whatever they want to do. They run them all the way back down to the end of the jetty where they have to bury the buckets completely, okay? Bury the buckets completely, then they sprint home to the finish. The whole team has to finish in order to become first place.
I can do it okay because this is actually really fun. I have the best teammate in the world.
That's the pain right there.
The inchworm.
Not the fucking carry.
No, it's definitely the inchworm.
That day, I was actually on my way into the city to work, and that was a late day for me, so I didn't have to go until 10 o'clock, and I got a call from my uncle saying, don't come into the city, there's something happened, and at the time, I was working at a paint store down on between Warren and Murray on Church, which was like 3 blocks from the Trade Center, and you know, a lot of people that I knew down there were down there the day it happened, and it was very chilling, and you know, I wanted to get there and do everything I could to help them. So it brings back a lot of memories, for sure.
I was in the Marines myself, so talking to the people that run this place, it's a beautiful thing that they're doing this for the Wounded Warriors. Got some friends over there right now, so it means a lot supporting these guys.
We're honored to just be here and you know, support those that help support our freedom, so
let's go,
definitely a good cause.
Who are you guys with?
I was in college.
John Conley. Died in 9/11. I'm gonna push for him right here.
Let's go, Tim.
Let's get there though. Let's get there though. Let's get there now.
Get up there in first place and they'll be done with this part of the workout.
That's all you think about, you know, you think about how much your shoulder's burning and your stomach hurts, and it's nothing compared to what
all
people go through,
was
so
the,
it keeps you
I'm
going.
I'm not doing this with bombs. Like, there's no bombs going off around me. I can just army crawl. It's cool.
Yeah. All right.
Think about them over there. They're amazing.
Yeah. We have the perfect conditions to army crawl, and we're complaining. You just go, you know. But it's inspiring, absolutely.